Hello and welcome back. This is the final video, me talking about the curve tools in Rhino. I know you can't wait to move forward and move on to the surfaces and solids and so on, but this stuff is important and we will not skip it. Last time we looked into, we stopped here in simplifying lines and arcs, and then now we will go through all these. And we will skip some of them, which we already did before, because they just reappear in that toolbar. And we looked at it before, the tween between two curves and so on. One of my most favorite tools actually in here is the Curve Boolean tool. We will not look at any tools where surfaces are involved. We look at that later. And then next video, before we actually jump into surfaces, I will go through, so we will build some simple geometry, but then we will look into the display modes. This is this stuff here and this stuff. So, you know, wireframe, rendered viewport and so on, and how we can modify it. And we'll look more into options in Rhino. And then we will also look into properties and layers. And then we can actually jump into the real cool stuff. Now, curve tools. Convert curve to polyline. Let's do it. So we have a curve and this convert. So I will go through that very quickly. And because you already know what's going on, you have all this. Yeah, my previous videos actually show you the workflow already for each of the tools. So, and they are not different. So convert curve to polyline. That already shows you what it does. It just converts the curve into a lot of small segments of lines. The second tool in here with right click is convert curve to arcs, which is also an option here. Output lines or arcs. I already covered the two options here. Simplify input, that would be if you have like extra points which are not needed. It simplifies first your line and then outputs your line or arcs. Delete input, you can either make a copy of what you're creating or you're gonna delete it. And angle tolerance, you can play with it. That makes it either less curves or less segments or more segments and so on and so on. And you can also, that's so cool, you can also you can select the output layer. So you could say here, output layer is either the current, which would be the one here, which is marked with a tick. That would be my output layer, and if I change that, I can actually choose the input layer. So actually where this object is current, where the line is currently, or where the curve is currently, in which layer it is. So it creates the copy in that same layer and not in the active layer. So that explains me. So we'll not go through all these options yet. Now, make periodic is an option to close a curve. So we can, let's do it like this. Make periodic, select the curves or surfaces. Yeah, they also work with surfaces. And then you can say smooth or not smooth. Yes, and it just squashes the thing together and it creates one closed curve. It's not very nice. Let's try it again. Let's choose smooth. Yes, it's a completely different output, but it creates a deformable closed curve without the kink. Yeah. Another option to close curve is this one. It's basically saying close. I always use the command here and it just adds a line between my start point and end point, close curve. Yeah, so again, just either click here or type the command. Then we have an extend function, which is specific for curves and control points. So continue control point curve. Okay, let's try that. It actually takes the last point and you can continue to draw your curve. That's pretty neat. I'm not using this often enough. And you can do the same with the interpolated curve. So you can actually choose the right click and draw the interpolated version of the curve. Then there's some commands about subcurves. That's very useful. So for example, let's try it. So you can actually delete sections of your curve if you want. Let's show you this again. So you choose a start point and then an end point. It's pretty good. You can, so these are all similar. They just do slightly different things. The extract subcurve, this tool extract subcurve actually only works with a polyline and poly arcs. So if I have a polyline and arc here and another arc and the line, then I can use this extract subcurve command. So then you can actually select the curve you want to extract. And then you have a copy of that. Either you can choose a copy or you can extract it. So it's basically it makes a copy of it. It actually breaks the or kind of explodes the curve only partially. Instead of like doing this, explodes and then putting these things together. That's also, that's what I did in the past. So this tool is actually just deletes the rest of the curve and only keeps the section I want. For example, I could go here and I want this portion here. Then works like that. Okay, you can go back. And then I can remove portions where I just want to cap or where I want to cut the curve. For example, I would like to do this. I can cut this here. Then I want to cut this. And then join. Then I have this curve. And this tool actually makes this much faster. So you can select here, and it actually cuts it already for me. And interestingly, so let's see how that is if this is closed. Close curve. Okay. That's closed. If I do this again, then yeah, it marks the section which is keep, which is will it will keep. Interesting. And then you can choose it that way. Pretty cool. We looked into tweens already, but we will not touch it again. We also looked into the offset multiple curves. We don't touch it again. And now, almost my favorite tool, which I use all the time, and it's very handy. So that's why I prepared some old master plan from some long time ago, just get rid of some stuff. So basically what I can do with this tool is to do some quite interesting Boolean operations on curves. So I can select all these curves here and then just mark the areas I want to extract as new outlines. And there are some options. So either delete the input, we saw that before. Combine regions, yes or no. In that case, yes, I want to have this as one area. But you can also have them separated, and it creates a lot of smaller regions. And output curve, yes. Simplify curves, yes, and so on. And then when I click this one, I have a new curve, which is the outline of what I marked. And why is this so cool? Is that because if you get a master plan like this, and most of these curves are single curves, they're not connected, then it's quite painful to combine all these areas. So for example, here you have, it seems like you have some water area here in the center. Let's get rid of all the, I'll get rid of all the trees first. So I go here, I can see where they are. 400 tree. Let's get the name. And I have some text. I select text. I delete the text now because I don't need it. I could also hide it or find the layer. And then I'm just left with a bunch of curves. And some of them are closed. So it's just some single lines. and here's some single lines. And to create surfaces out of these is quite painful if you don't know this tool. Of course, here it's nice because it's a closed surface and I can just use my, which create surface from planar curves. That just creates a surface here. If I want to have this thing as a as one surface, it becomes quite tedious. No, it's like, okay, you need to first cut this here. So in the past, I was doing this. Cut this here in my early years. So I cut this here, then I need to cut this here. And then I need to cut that here again. And sometimes it doesn't work because this is not aligned. It's not overlapping either. And then this is not aligned, so I have to add another curve here or here. I need to decide. It's quite annoying. And then this one need to be, either I draw a new line here just to connect these, or I use my my closed curve line, and then I just build this. And then I have closed curve, and from that I can create a surface. It's quite a lot of steps. So yeah, I prepared this plan, and just show you on a smaller portion maybe on how that works. Maybe let's try this. So just this portion here, and we'll draw like a rectangle because that will help me. So there's a path system and there's some buildings, and I want to basically have this area is water, then you have a beach, we have the walkway, and we have this buildings here, and the rest is landscape, the rest is green, and here's also water surface. So I created several layers here: water, softscape, roads, paths, beach. And just give it a material quickly. Okay, I have my layers here. Oh yeah, buildings. Buildings. Let's do it. So I just mark this area here. We're gonna start from left to the right. So we select everything which is connected. Then we use our curve boolean tool. Sometimes if you select too many lines, it could take a while. But yeah, actually normally it goes quick. So we are in the water. Let's do water first. That's it. Now I can right away create the surface and go here and rendered viewport. It's already there. Let's go here. Let's keep it unshaded. And if you lost the selection now, it's, by the way, you can always select the last objects. So for example, if I would have created my surfaces in the wrong layer, I can actually do this, select last, and then put it wherever I need to. We can just do it like this, then we do the softscape, or let's do the roads first. Roads, so this is the roads, the others I would consider paths. Well, let's do it like this. If you want to give this a different material, you can also use this command to combine regions. Yes or no, you can actually do no, and then this will be separated. Okay, so I think that should work. And we can do this. Yeah, worked really good. So these are roads. It was already connected, so I didn't, but you can. If you use the other command where it's not combining the areas, then you would have this as a separate surface. And you can always cut it if you want. Okay, that's this. So we have, can mark all the buildings. Bring it to here, mark buildings. And now instead of, so now for example, if you would lose the selection now, I can still get it back. I mean, now it's of course because they are on this layer, I could actually select the objects or can do select last. That selects my objects again. And then I can do, for example, extrude curve because we want to create a massing for the building. Extrude curves. And here we need to go on solid, yes. So S solid. And then let's say they are around 20 meters tall. And for sure there are different sizes, but just for now to explain you how that works. Can then again select our stuff. We'll select the beach. And now we softscape, do a softscape. And yeah, and then one last thing, walkways and pedestrian walkways, pedestrian walkway here. Now, if I go on rendered view, then we have a very simple but basic 3D model. It's actually just surfaces, but you can do a lot of this already. And yeah, you can see how quickly actually you can fill these areas with surfaces, which is quite amazing. I just forgot something here. It doesn't matter. It's I just want to show you how you could start to work. And then of course if you don't want to see the curves, turn the curves off and we have our 3D model. 3D, it's not 3D yet because we don't have any elevation levels and stuff like that. But it's a good start. I think that's pretty much it. Now I can just show you very quickly these. I think we have done that before, but just to bring this portion to a close. So mark endpoint, it's very simple. Mark start point, endpoint. I think this is start point, yes. So start point and endpoint, if I right click, then show curve ends. I mean, I'm not sure if. Yeah, it just shows you the curve ends until you close this window, I think. Guidelines, they're quite interesting. So guidelines, actually, they kind of live in their own world. So I can create a guideline like this. They are endless, they just continue. And they're only visible when you draw. So now when I draw something, they appear and I can use them as construction line. That's it. Next time we go into the modes, display modes. Very interesting stuff. See you. And let me know if you have any questions.